I created a magical book in CapCut that can answer any question you have. It's better than ChatGPT. Let's ask it. I want a 3D camera in CapCut. Okay, I know it's your question too, and everyone has asked me before, so let's see what it says. Oh wait, what the? Let me try again. Is good bud, I want, okay. I think I broke it. So, in this video, we are going to create this shot together as you see. This technique was used in the Harry Potter movie. Even Magnets Media has used this technique in their videos too. And because I love you guys, I'll tell you about a new hidden update that can make your CapCut timeline like an Adobe timeline to edit faster. So watch this video carefully. So let's get started. First, import your layers into the timeline. First the table, then the notebook, and finally the hand layer. Make sure the ratio is set to 16:9. Then, scale the wood layer. The book should be smaller than the hand, or it can be bigger too, because it's a magical book. Select all layers and increase the duration to 10 seconds. Now, for text, you should add a text layer. Write, "I want 3D camera in CapCut," because it's a magical notebook, and it's a little similar to a teenager diary book. We should write big words, so press enter between camera and in word. Rotate it a little bit. Now you need a handwriting font. I found this font, Atomic Marker. You can find a lot of handwriting fonts by searching on Google or using these sites. Change the color to dark red, like black blood. For animating text, go to the animation part and find any animation that has a soft wipe. Choose type 2 because our project is a little magical, and we need wipe text. But you can use type 1 animation too, but your project should be about writing a letter or newspaper. So, click on type 2 and increase the duration to get a slower animation. For the end, you should use the dissolve animation because the book should eat the text. Or how should I explain it? It's like the text should be drawn into the book. Increase the duration for the end too. Now, duplicate the first text layer and have the book say, "I can give you money instead." For the in animation, you should use dissolve, not wipe animation, because it doesn't type. It reveals text. Select all layers instead of text layers and increase the duration. Now, duplicate the first text layer and say, "Money is good, but I want 3D camera." And the book is dead. For emojis, press Windows and dot on your keyboard to place 5 emojis around the page. Some of them should be big, and some of them should be small. Before we start the next part, let's introduce the sponsor of this video, Wondershare UniConverter. They have a great toolbox for editors, offering a variety of tools including a video compressor. Just import your video, click here to select your compression level. I choose the recommended range, then click OK and compress. This way you can reduce the size of your video without losing quality, as you can see on screen. This allows you to quickly share your videos with clients and friends on social media. Check the first link in the description to try it out. Now, for animating the hand to write text. First, it should be out of the shot, so move it and put it here. Now, create keyframes for all positions and rotations. But we don't want to change the scale, so don't touch these parts at all. The hand should follow the text animation. First, it starts from here, then goes up. When the text is done, move it down and continue like this. When the text animation is finished, as you can see it from here, now move the hand to the right side to wait for the book's answer. From here, you can see how much you should wait for it. Let's check the animation. We should move the text layer to the left side so that the hand and text animation start together. Move the keyframes as well to ensure the timing matches the text layer. For this part, when the hand writes the text, you can create a keyframe at this position. Continue like this to animate the hand for the next text too. I sped up the video a little bit to see the process a little faster. But for the end of the animation, move the hand out of the shot when the emojis are gone to get a loop animation. If you look at the animation, you will realize that it's not smooth. So, right-click on it and change keyframes to auto curve to get smooth animation. You should do this for position X, Y axes, and for rotation. So, click on keyframes, then click on auto curve and continue like this for all keyframes. When I was editing this part, I realized I forgot to tell you this part. I changed the rotation a little bit to get this beautiful hand movement. Rotate it a little bit to left side. Then go farther and rotate it to right side. Now you get a curve movement like this. Okay, now right-click on it and create a compound clip. Why do I do it? Because your animation should have some motion blur. So go to Video Basics and turn on Motion Blur. Set numbers on 40 or lower. Don't move anything, just wait for processing. Now look before and after using Motion Blur. I think I should make a video just for Motion Blur and CapCut. What do you think, guys? Tell me in the comments. We animate the hand, but if you look around, you will realize that your hands have some random movements in real life. So go to the Effect part and add Play Pendulum. Apply it to the hand layer. Set twist to 0, strength to 15, sharpen to 10, and speed between 30 to 50. You don't need to animate the hand for random movements by your hand. Just use this effect. For color grading, I think a night scene with candlelight should be good. First, select the table layer. Decrease saturation, exposure, highlight, shadow, and brightness, but increase contrast. Just play around with the numbers to get a dark color. If you have a table with dark wood, there's no need to change the color. However, you can't turn dark wood into light wood. As you can see on the screen, you have more control over light wood. Add clarity and vignette to get light at the center and shadow around the corners. For the book, change all settings. But for here, reduce shadow to get a darker book, because it's night. Add an adjustment layer on top of all layers. Increase vignette to get shadow around the screen, and increase clarity a little bit. For the hand, because it's brighter than other layers, it should be a little darker, with the same settings. We need to create a shadow for the hand. But let me explain a little about lighting, because I know they didn't teach you these things in school. So, light comes from the top, so the shadow should be under the hand like this. But if the light moves to the right, the shadows should be on the left. This happens with the sun, candles, and any light in your beautiful life. So, duplicate the hand layer by holding Alt and move it under the hand layer. Now, reduce all brightness settings in the adjustment layer. If you see it doesn't work well, go to the curve part and reduce brightness too. You can change opacity too to get a stronger or lighter shadow. But as you can see, it's a sharp shadow and not realistic. It should be softer, so add a motion blur effect and set the horizontal to 52 or 48. Why should you do that? Because it's like this. 50 all layers on top of each other. But when you move them to 52, you can see layers. For the second part, we need four hands to point at something. But what or where do they point? I think they know the chosen boy destroyed that magical boy. Oh, right. They're looking for me. I should run, but before that, let's create this shot together. First, select all layers and cut the right side by pressing the W key on your keyboard. This will help cut extra frames to get a clean timeline. Increase the adjustment layer and table layer, because we need them for the end of the shot. Add the chosen boy's image and position it at the center of the shot. Animate the image so it comes from down to up. Create a keyframe at the desired position. Then, go to the beginning of the layer and move it down. Right-click, show keyframe animation and use autocurve or graphs because both method works fine. Now, add a hand into the shot. You can use different hands or duplicate the existing ones and mirror the layers to get different hand positions. I speed up the video to see the process faster. Position the hands around the boy's face. For animating, I don't suggest using the standard animation tools for this part, as they are limited to four directions: left, right, up, and down. Instead, animate the hands the same way you animated the boy's image. I speed up the video to see the process faster. By the end, you should have an animation where the boy rises and the hands point at his face. Smooth the keyframes like before, so I won't mention it again because you already know how to do it. If you're waiting for the CapCut update, as mentioned at the beginning of the video, you should know that now you can access the original layers after creating a compound clip. In previous versions, you had to undo the compound clip, but now you can simply double-click on the compound clip layer to see the hand layer. You can change keyframes, or anything else you want. To return to the original timeline, just click here, and you're done. With this feature, CapCut has a timeline similar to other software like After Effects and Premiere Pro. Create compound clips for all hands, but separately. This way, you can add movement effects to them, like the play pendulum effect. Set twist to 10, strength to 10, and sharpen to 10 as well. When you add the play pendulum effect to all hands, start changing the numbers to get random movements. Let's check the animation. For color grading, first change the background color. Cut the adjustment layer and animate exposure from 0 to negative 40. This way you change background light and increase focus on the subject. Select all hands together and change their color to make them a little darker. Decrease the highlight a bit, then add a vignette to create shadows around the hands. Finally, add clarity and reduce brilliance to decrease brightness in some parts of the hands. Yeah, this is our final animation we made together. If you want to see more videos like this, just click on this playlist. And remember, as always, stay creative.